I would like to call a regular meeting of the Board of Trustees of March 14 to order. Would you kindly join the board and myself in the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America? I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Clerk Bruce, would you kindly call the roll?
Trustee Adler is not here. Trustee Barr?
Present.
Trustee Manzo isn't here. Trustee Moy?
Here.
Trustee Tiesinger?
Present.
Trustee Youssef?
Here.
And President Lamalani?
Here. We do have a quorum. Let's start with the opening comments. First of all, next Monday morning on the 20th, several of the board members and the staff will be attending the annual meeting of the Greater Oak Brook Chamber, which includes breakfast and awards presentation at the Marriott Hotel in Oak Brook. I look forward to presenting the welcoming remarks to everyone in attendance next Monday as we value the relationship between our retail as well as our commercial sector. Oak Brook remains open for business and we need to do everything we can to try to increase the business friendliness of our staff as well as the board, and we need to reach out to them and welcome them and work together with them. Also, the speaker for that morning will be the CEO of the Chamberlain Group, which is Joanna Schoik. As you know, the Chamberlain Group under Jutuchua's headquarters, they moved to their building, and I just found out from Bob they moved a couple of weeks ago, and about 650 people have actually moved in to that Chamberlain building out on York Road. So we want to welcome them all, and I think we're going to have a positive and an upbeat relationship with the Chamberlain Group as well as the others that are there. Finally, as you many of you know, this Friday is St. Patrick's Day. Please make responsible and safe choices if you decide to celebrate St. Patrick's Day. The Oak Brook Police Department, along with the police department throughout the state, will be out monitoring the roads. So plan your parties, but don't drink and drive. Thank you. That concludes my brief report. Are there any visitor comments, Charlotte?
Yes, I have two people. Okay. Alisa Gaddis is first.
Good evening. My name is Elise Gaddis, and I grew up in Oak Brook attending the Bath and Tennis Club. Like many others, I have the fondest memories there and was so thrilled to move my family here in 2010, where my three kids have swam on swim team for 7 years. I understand you're all probably tired of complaints regarding the name change, so I'll be brief. Oak Brook is a very unique place to live, and I think everyone would agree to that. The Bath and Tennis Club made us unique from the rest of the swim clubs, so I feel why should we be just like everybody else? Dr. Lamalani, when I moved here in 2010, you were running for village president, and at that time, at many functions, you were promoting free membership to Oak Brook residents. While that sounded appealing to many of us, we really feared that the pool would close down permanently due to lack of funds. Residents are happy to pay for this amenity, but only when the membership fee is fair and reasonable. The increase in your membership fees has forced me and many other families to look at other community pools. My 17-year-old daughter is now done with swim team, but my 15-year-old twins, with their friends, assumed that they would swim for OBBT until the age of 18. My 15-year-olds are the only ones who swim in my household, so for me to purchase an $850 membership for two kids to sometimes do swim team is simply not doable. Your individual membership fee is $475, and with two kids, that's more than the family membership. Looking at other pools in the area, the Hinsdale Community Pool has an individual rate that is $260. Clarendon Hills Pool has an individual rate that is only $175. The swim team is now going to lose many of its high school swimmers, resulting in less points earned at the swim meets. You should be targeting high schoolers and not driving them away. They still want a pool to swim at, and this community needs something for high school kids to do. We don't have a town. They won't be at the pool very often due to their other activities, and you'd make more money on many individual memberships. High school kids want to be at the pool with their friends, but now that these Oak Brook kids are at Hinsdale Central, their friends are now at the Hinsdale and Clarendon Hills pools. You should also be trying to retain your longtime members, not driving us away. It was sad last week when my kids asked me if they were going to swim at OBBT again this summer. And I had to tell them no, because it is no longer reasonable for us to join our community pool. Thank you for your time.
Okay. George Schenk.
Hi, George Sharuk, resident of Oak Brook, member of Oak Brook Bath and Tennis Club. Golf memberships have not increased fourfold at the swim and tennis club. It pains me to say that. But certain programs have increased fourfold. I don't know if you're aware of that. If you compare Oak Brook Bath and Tennis Club rates versus the Park District rates for some programs, these programs have not increased at that same rate. They are not 10 times more valuable at OBBT as they are at the Park District, right? Golf has had no increase. I don't understand that. Obviously, for vocal residents like myself, who swim, seems to be that we're taking the brunt of the increases for the cost. I understand that as a city, we're paying $500,000 to keep Oak Brook Bath and Tennis Club afloat. I'm aware of that. But for residents who swim, we're the ones taking the brunt of it, not the golfers, who are the trustees. Many of the trustees are golfers. I'd like to see an equal increase for everybody. Doesn't that seem fair? Is there collusion going on here, Chris? Trustee members? I received this in the mail. Very pretty, very nice. It says Mr. Barr has a proven record of support for our community organizations, Oak Brook Bath and Tennis Club, not listed. But Friends of the Oak Brook Public Library, Civic Association, Ground Mill, Mays Lake, Fullenberg's Historical Society, Oak Brook Historical Society, looks great. What about OBBT? So I guess I'm the scapegoat. I'll be going to Hinsdale or wherever else you guys want me to go. I'll go to the Park District, Chris, where it's 10 times cheaper to do the same program that we have at OBBT. Is that fair?
Okay. No one else has signed up.
I just want to make a quick comment, and the trustees are welcome to make comments during the trustee segments. But as your village president, I've heard you loud and clear. I actually received two emails from Angie, one from Angie Lopez and the second one from Kathy Merrick within the last couple of hours, and I responded to both of you. I believe Angie is here, but I don't quite see her. Oh, right here, yeah. And Kathy, I don't know if she's here or not, but I did respond to both of you via email that, number one, I apologize that the sports core committee has not met for a long time. And many of these issues, some of the issues that Chris has brought up, Chris is a young and very resourceful man, but I think there are a lot of stuff that we need to be discussing at the level of the sports core committee. And a lot of this debate and discussion and consensus needs to be built at the sports core committee. We have some outstanding members in the sports core committee. And I'm actually going to be talking to Trustee Barr, who chairs the sports core committee, after the meeting is over, to see if we could call a meeting of the sports core committee, long-range planning committee, and discuss many of the issues that both Kathy as well as Angie brought out. And very clearly, I can understand their concerns, and we need to address all these concerns, because we are all here, all the trustees as well as myself, we are all here to serve our residents. And if we can't serve our residents, we have no business of being here. So I will be talking to, if you would give me some patience and some understanding here, I will be talking to Chairman John Barr after the meeting is over, and hopefully setting up a meeting rather soon to discuss many issues. You brought out some of the issues, and there are other issues. We're going to discuss all of that in the next week or two, whenever Trustee Bauer can bring it out. Yeah.
In fact, Mr. President, Ms. Lopez and I were talking before this meeting, and we have a meeting set up for 6:30 next Tuesday, and any of you who are interested in joining us in that meeting, you're pleased to come, and I'll be inviting other people who are on the Long Range Planning Committee there, and I'll be explaining a few things there a little bit more. So that's my invitation. Next Tuesday, 6:30, up here at the conference room.
Yeah, I think we should invite all the members of the Sports Corps Committee, as well as the liaison trustees and whoever else may be interested. It's going to be a notice meeting, so if there are anybody else who is interested in coming or any trustees who are interested, we should all invite them, and we would like to address all these issues one by one to your satisfaction. That concludes my report. If there's anybody else here who wants to speak, otherwise we'll move on. Yeah. And we have some Sports Corps related items on the agenda as well, so feel free to stay if you would like to stay. Yeah. Thank you. Let's move on with the approval of the minutes. Item number 5, may I have a motion for approval of the minutes from the meeting of February 28, 2017?
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes. Yes.
Any objection? Motion carried. I will now move on and direct your attention to the screen where the consent agenda is available for your viewing. Does any board member wish to have any item removed from the consent agenda? Tasinga? Yeah.
Yes, 6D2 and 6D3, please.
6D2 and 6D3. Any other extractions? Seeing none, may I now have a motion to approve the consent agenda with the exception of those two extractions and authorize the expenditures?
So moved.
Second.
Clerk Brooks, can I have a roll call vote again?
Trustee Barr?
Yes.
Trustee Moy?
Yes.
Trustee Tiesinga?
Yes.
Trustee Youssef?
Yes.
Thank you. Motion carries. Trustee Tiesinga, would you want to deal with these extracted items, D2 and 3?
Yes, thank you, President Lamalani. 6D2 is a resolution about the tollway expansion. And I wanted to extract this because I don't feel that I can join it, and I needed a way to register my dissent to the language used in this resolution. The resolution says that Oak Brook is opposing the expansion. We accuse the tollway authority of acting in secret. We accuse them of leaking information, doing something disastrous. We pledge ourselves to try and stop the expansion because we say it's violating federal laws. And we say it's totally unnecessary. Now, as part of my work with the DuPage Mayors and Managers Conference, I review information from the Chicago Metropolitan Agency for Planning, which used to be called the Northern Illinois Planning Agency. The Tollway Authority has 286 miles of road, and in the next 31 years, which is the planning cycle till 2050, they're going to receive in toll revenue $2.73 billion per year. The biggest expenditure of funds in Illinois on roads is $84.8 billion in the next 31 years. And I think they've made a convincing case that 294 needs to be expanded. There's a way to do it while respecting the noise concerns and all the other concerns of the people who live next to it. But to call Bob Schillerstrom, a guy who works in secret, a guy who is doing something disastrous, and someone who needs to be stopped, is, I don't think, responsible to say something like that to somebody who's trying to lead a rather large agency. Bob Schillerstrom has been the chairman of the DuPage County Board. He's the son of Glenn Schillerstrom, who is a well-known attorney who signed my membership certificate when I became an attorney in 1984 with the DuPage County Bar Association. And so I can't add my voice to a resolution dragging him down and accusing him of bad behavior when I think this whole agency not only are trying to do something reasonable, but they have to do it. And in the final analysis, they will do it with their $84.8 billion in the next 31 years. So I don't want to be on the wrong side of this using inappropriate language in this resolution. So I don't want to say let's change it. I don't want to say don't pass it, but I can't add my voice to it tonight, so I needed to extract it.
I would like the board and the residents to know that Trustee Tasinga and I had a conversation on this, and I actually agree with you that we need to sort of, and I mentioned this to you yesterday too, maybe tone down the language a little bit, because Bob Shillerstrom is willing to work with us. I actually talked to him about 2 weeks ago, and he's actually planning to meet Rick Jannex, the manager, and I believe, when is it, in about a month or so?
Yeah,
he's planning to meet us and talk to us and listen to us and address some of the concerns that we have brought up in the last two meetings. So I would like to soften the tone of this resolution and make it a little more...
Well, then a motion...
Just like we are being business friendly, we need to be friendly with Bob Shillerstrom as well.
Well, then I think a motion to table it...
Yeah. Would you like would to make a motion to table?
I'll make that motion.
Okay. Second?
Second,
yeah.
Second. Any further discussion on tabling?
No discussion on table.
Okay, all right. Yeah. All those, and we'll just go ahead and table it, and we'll come up with an improved version then.
You have to ask for the vote.
Thank you.
Voice vote is fine.
Okay, all those in favor of tabling this particular resolution to 117 ISTAR 1626?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, motion carries. Next, second item you extracted, Trustee Tasinga.
Yes, thank you, President Lamalani. This is just a technicality. I needed to extract this because I'd like to be recused from the vote on this. In the past, I've represented this company as a client of our law firm. I did not represent them during the period of this bid and no longer represent them. Out of an abundance of caution, I feel like I should not vote on this contract.
Okay.
So,
Any further discussion? Yeah.
Mr. President,
yeah.
I'll move the approval of the contract with... Loving Clean Sweep.
Second.
And I'd like to ask our Public Works Director for more clarification on this explanation.
Last year we tried running a contract for streets.
I don't know if your mic is on.
Mike.
Last year we tried running a contract sweeping service instead of in-house. Pleasantly surprised, overwhelmed at how well they did. They came in, we had the general meeting with them, went over our areas. They suggested doing some things a little different than we did because we had the sweeper out 5 days a week. We'd come in early on Friday and do the commercial. They suggested some other ways of getting more lane miles because they're working during the day, they're out with the traffic, they take all the spoil away instead of us having to haul it away. The one thing I was impressed with is through the few years I've been dealing with Public Works, it was always don't do this because you'll lose, you can't get the service that you can do in-house. Everyone's wrong. You can get some good service by doing this. There's no maintenance on the machine. We still have the machine for emergency services. We were out cleaning up leaves the end of the year. We changed the contract this year that we can use them further into the winter as long as the weather is still dry and warm enough that their water won't freeze. They will be sweeping up our leaves too. So it, to me, it's a truly win-win situation.
And I think this is part of what everyone's been asked to do within the village is there some way that we can improve services to the village than the residents by outsourcing certain things and doing it at a reduced cost?
Yes, and the other big positive for me on this is we used to have a gentleman that for 5 days during the summer months was driving the street sweeper. He's now back on the street and starting to work on signs. So we get a body back and we get the services done better and cheaper.
Excellent.
Okay, any further discussion? Roll call vote, please.
Trustee Barr?
Yes.
Trustee Moy?
Yes.
And Trustee Teasing abstained. Trustee?
He recused himself.
Yeah, he recused.
And?
Three trustees, okay then?
Yeah, Trustee Youssef?
Yes.
I'll have to.
Okay, President Lamalani?
Love this, yeah, voting this time, yes.
That gives me four.
Very good, thank you. Moving on, we're really at supersonic speed today. 8A, Swim and Tennis Clubhouse Renovation Project. Trustee Bauer, would you kindly update the board on the Swim and Tennis Clubhouse renovation?
Well, I'd like to introduce Chris Thompson, who's the Swim and Tennis Club manager, to do this. I've been over there, and it's under construction, and some very nice things are happening.
Good evening. So just very quickly, just want to go through a few slides, kind of give you guys an idea of where we're at right now with some of the renovation project happening over at the clubhouse. So first thing we've done is remove the mirrored columns from all the beams. So the current picture up there is what they look like actually as of a couple days ago. We've had them here all week, so we have wood sanded all over the entire clubhouse at the moment, but it's already being patched up and will be stained and completed by either the end of this week or Monday of next week. We are replacing the carpeted area that you see in the bottom picture there. It will be replaced with the luxury vinyl on the picture on the right. So looking to have a more usable surface, especially for when people are spilling in spots on the carpet. We won't have to worry about that anymore. And then the vinyl tile is going to last a lot longer and have better wear and tear than what the carpeting will have as well. We are switching out all the light fixtures in that room. The picture on the top is a five-tier chandelier that will go through. There's five lights that we have down the middle of the clubhouse, so those will get placed there. And the picture on the bottom right is going to be 12 of those round drums will go around the entire perimeter as well. So it'll be a nice update and more of a modern look and a little bit more elegance as well into the rentals for the clubhouse. Our office desperately needed some upkeep, not only for when members are coming in to get to renew, potential new members coming in to get some information, people coming in for events, to have a nice inviting place that looks friendly and clean and neat. So we're excited to be getting some new carpeting in there and also repainting and getting some nicer decor for pictures up on our wall as well. Hopefully by May 1st, we will have a new sign out on 31st Street. It's going to be an internally lit LCD sign, so you'll be able to see our name and logo there, nice and bright all day and evening long. Also added the words wedding, corporate, and banquets. Actually, it's an outdated sign. It's not going to say banquets on it. But it's there to help promote our club so that we can drive and swim, tennis, and all of our rentals as well. So really hoping that's going to be a nice improvement and really the first impression that you have of the club as you drive by. And then the last updates we have are out at the pool for the summer, so we're very excited. The pictures on the left are the current Chase lounge chairs and regular chairs that we have. So they're all a green strap, kind of a very dated and not really the impression that I think our members would like, as well as what I would like to have for us being a private club. So the ones on the right are, it's a full sling. So the nice thing is if those were to get damaged, you can replace just the material. You're not replacing the entire component as well. And it won't rust, stain, fade ever based on the material that it's made of as well. So it will last a lot longer as well. And then we're also excited about updating the furniture for the poolside cafe. The pictures on the left, you can see it's not those are not aluminum because they're all starting to rust and crack and break. So there's some safety issues with it actually cutting you because a lot of the broken pieces. But overall, there's a lot of rust on there. So the picture on the right, you can see it's the same line of furniture as the items that we'll have out at the pool as well. So it's just going to be a nice feature to really improve the overall image that we have of the club and really, I think, what our members are expecting and wanting to see. And this was their number one comment on a survey that we sent out to all the members last summer on changes, things that they'd like to see at the club. The lounge chairs out at the pool and the dining equipment were the number one area that they wanted to see change first. And that is my presentation.
Any questions or clarification? Is everybody satisfied? Okay, seeing none, move on to the next one, 8B. Trustee Bauer, would you present resolution R1622 pertaining to the, I believe, Tasty contract or catering contract and make the appropriate motion?
I'd like to move that the Village Board award a professional service agreement to Tasty Catering to cater events at the clubhouse and approve resolution 1622.
Second.
Okay, and
discussion?
As a preface to voting, I'd like to say that we still control the clubhouse. We control everything there is about it, the scheduling of events. We charge a rent for this. This is just a contract with Tasty for their professional services for their catering. So they're our go-to caterer. Chris, correct me if I say anything incorrect. But one of the things we're going to get from them is marketing that we don't have right now. And they're going to do their best to try to fill up this space for us. We do about 50 weddings right now, some corporate events and like that. I think, Chris, you told me we need about 150 to make this viable and not lose money with the clubhouse. So this is an attempt that Chris has looked at a lot of different caterers. This is a person who's responsible and really wants to make the clubhouse a success as a venue for things like weddings and events. And I think we should pass this.
Any further discussion? Yes, Trustee Yusuf?
I'm in agreement. We're giving them first shot at it. It's not an exclusive. It's not an absolute no choice. There'll still be choices to use other approved caterers should you have specialty tastes that that you want somebody who specializes in a certain type of food. But they will commit to that. They're committing to some improvements in the kitchen, and hopefully their efforts will pay off. They do a lot of functions there now, and we've got experience dealing with them. And to my understanding, it's all been positive, and that's really what drove the choice.
And we're only obligated to a one-year contract. The contract actually is terminable on 90 days' notice. Certainly hopeful that this will enter into a multi-year contract, and maybe as we learn more in dealing with them, there may be other terms and conditions that we can put into the contract. But in terms of their desire to come in, I think, and really do a terrific job, I feel that the village is very adequately protected.
I'd actually like to take a moment to thank our attorney, Stuart Diamond, as well as Rick Genex, for working on a lot of the enhancements. There have been some improvements in this contract since the one a couple of weeks ago, and as well as Chris. Is he here from the Tasty? No. Okay. So there have been certain improvements made in this contract, and I think it looks a lot better than what it looked a couple of weeks ago. If I had to do this over again, I would have done it somewhat differently. I would have included the input from the Sports Corps Long-Range Planning Committee. But that's water under the dam, and we have come this far, and I think we need to move forward. But in the future, any issues related to the Sports Corps Committee needs to go to the committee first before it even comes to the board. But we have just gone too far, and I apologize. I would like to seek your apology for happening the way it happened. It shouldn't have happened that way. But I do want to thank you. A lot of the improvements were made. In particular, I was concerned about the fact that in the previous contract, there was no opportunity for an Oak Brook resident, if he wanted to have his own caterer, instead of the Tasty, for example, even though I believe Tasty is pretty tasty, I believe, but I think if someone wants their own caterer, if there's some ethnic issues or something, or they want ethnic type of food or a different type of cooking, like I'm a vegetarian, for example, so I don't like food either cooked in the utensils where they're making meat and so on and so forth, so I would like to have a different type of a caterer. The previous contract was not allowing me to do that unless it's 60 days prior to the event. And you, as you know very well, we book weddings a year in advance. So if you're going to cut my fingers off and say, well, you can only do it 60 days before the event, it wouldn't have worked. But I want to thank Chris and Rick as well as you for including that particular thing where you can actually do it way in advance if you want to go with some other caterer. So that's a significant improvement to what we had. So I'm also very happy with the changes that were made here. If there are any other comments? Ed, did you want to say something? Yeah. You good? Seeing no further discussion, I can't believe we're moving this fast. It's the shortest meeting we've had. Can we have a roll call vote, please?
Yeah. Let's make this a practice.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Roll call vote. Yeah.
Trustee Barr?
Yes.
Trustee Moy?
Yes.
Trustee Tiesinger?
Yes.
Trustee Youssef?
Yes.
That's four votes.
All right. Information and updates. Rick?
No.
We have one more.
Oh, we have one more item?
Okay. Me too.
It's not on my script here.
Chief.
Okay, one other item, yes. A resolution approving the waiver of competitive bidding and authorizing the purchase of police vehicles from Miles Chevrolet and Curry Motors, R1621. Trustee Barr, you still have the floor.
I'll defer to the chief to explain this and why we need to replace three vehicles.
All right. Thank you very much, Trustee Barr. I know this came up on the agenda a couple weeks ago, and the board was looking for some more information, so I hope you were able to review my memoranda that I put in the packet for the board. But just to kind of go over it very quickly is that our request this year was actually reduced to three vehicles due to some repurposing and extending out some vehicles in the past. The budgeted amount is $115,500 through the Equipment Replacement Fund. $95,800 of that is for the actual vehicle purchase, and then another $19,700 for the equipment transfer and the emergency equipment. We're purchasing the vehicles through either the Suburban Purchasing Cooperative or the State of Illinois Central Management System bidding. And the reason we come to you this time of year and usually towards the end of February, beginning of March, is because all the state bid pricing is due in March, and so we have to put the orders in by March for the year in order for the bill to make it. Just to kind of recap and some things that I mentioned in my memo, as we look at these vehicles, we go through a holistic approach looking at mileage, usage, wear and tear, their maintenance history, and so forth, and really looking at as a fleet, not just as the vehicles themselves, but also what their intended uses for are appropriate. In this case, as you've seen, I've kind of marked out the next 5 years on what we're slated to purchase going through the plan. And one of the things that we're trying to be very mindful of course, is that as you remember, a year or so ago, we lost two vehicles that were totaled, and at which time we did were able to receive approximately $45,000 back into the equipment replacement fund through the insurance payments back to the village, since we weren't at fault on the two accidents. But what that did do is that sped up the purchase of two vehicles sooner than we would have normally done. But what that will do is that they'll time out at the same time as well. So you'll see in 2019, right now we're slated to have eight vehicles purchased, which is, you know, a little high in one single year. So my main concern is that if we were to push vehicles, that we would have a concern that we would end up even having to buy more vehicles in a given year than what we've got plotted out already. Just to kind of go through the three vehicles that we're looking at and some of the reasoning, Unit 303 is a primary patrol unit. It's actually our last rear-wheel drive squad that we have. One of the things that I've done since I've gotten here is that we've transitioned to either four-wheel or all-wheel drive vehicles. One of the things that's helped make that possible is that Chevrolet finally came out with a police pursuit rated 4x4 Tahoe a few years ago. So when we bought that particular vehicle in 2014, they still weren't available, but then in 2015, Chevy came out with that version, so we were able to start transitioning. Also, I've made it a priority that all the vehicles we purchase have backup cameras for safety, and also since there was a change in state law, although there is a police or an emergency vehicle exemption for Bluetooth, I think it's important that we demonstrate and be an example to the rest of the motoring public that that our personnel aren't on a phone either while they're working in the vehicle, even though, you know, I'm well aware that most of the phone calls our people make in a squad are work-related, but I still want to make sure that they're not seen talking on a phone either, and I think that that's important. 313 is one of the last Ford Escape. There was a decision made to buy Ford Escapes prior to me coming to Oak Brook, and since that time we've had some significant challenges just because they were basically family vehicles that were transitioned. So putting electrical equipment in there, you know, our police emergency lighting and sirens were an issue. One was used as a CSO vehicle that we had was down more than it was up, even in its first few years. And then last year we took two of the Escapes and were able to repurpose them and transfer them for use in public works that worked out well for them. So this is our last one that already is a five-year-old vehicle that we need to transition out of. And then the last vehicle we're looking for, 316, is being used as a CSO vehicle. It was actually the watch commander's vehicle for the first 3 years of its use, so we really began to stretch that vehicle out already 2 years past its intended use by repurposing it for as one of our CSO vehicles. But now that's had some starting to exhibit some repairs as well that we need to take a look at. One of the things I think is very interesting and something to really keep in mind is the significant resale value that we've been able to have, I think attributed to the type of vehicle it is, the fact that they're under 100,000 miles when we get rid of them, and that they're still primarily under warranty. That if you would have told me that we'd get $14,000 for a squad on iBid, I remember the days when you were lucky to get $500 for a squad after you were finished with it. So the fact that we're able to get $14,000 back on a vehicle, the fact that it's still under warranty, and you know, I remember the days of having to have an engine or a transmission replaced not under warranty because you couldn't get extended warranties for them, and end up having to pay $4,000 or $5,000 to have a new engine put in. So, in my mind, this is at least a $10,000 positive transitioning the cars when we do. So between that, the safety issues of I think are the handling and stability of having all four-wheel or all-wheel drive squads, because I can tell you, you know, even in a year like this when, you know, we haven't had much snow, is that the two-wheel Tahoes, because they're light in the back, were even a challenge in wet weather as well. And I know that when I first got here that I'd have officers be concerned with sliding around in those because actually the rear ends were not quite as stable as even a Crown Vic because of the weight, you know, like having an empty pickup truck in the back end. And then really, you know, I think in keeping with the philosophy that we've had the last 4 or 5 years in transitioning the vehicles, I think having a tremendous resale value and also not doing what some communities do where they drive them till the wheels fall off. Even in those communities, they would transition out of frontline law enforcement work at about the same mileage we would get rid of them anyway, but then transition them for other uses within the village, whether it's building or public works or pool cars. But then that's when the maintenance starts exponentially, when you start to have problems. They're not designed for, or, you know, because they're designed for law enforcement heavy duty use, they're using more gasoline, and to be used as pool cars or for light duty use didn't seem to make a lot of sense, where what we're doing now, they were able to purchase vehicles for that use. The miles are kept down. They're going to be able to be kept, what do you think, Doug, eight years or so maybe, and use half the gas, I think just makes a lot of sense from being cost effective and being good stewards. So
I'll move that the village board waive further bidding since the state of Illinois already conducted the bid process and issue a purchase order to Miles Chevrolet, Decatur, Illinois, for one 2017 Chevrolet Tahoe PBV Police Interceptor four-wheel drive in the amount of $37,508. Further, I move that the village board waive further bidding since the Suburban Purchasing Cooperative already conducted the bid process and issue a purchase order to Curry Motors, Frankfort, Illinois, for two 2017 Ford Utility Police Interceptors all-wheel drive in the amount of $58,292, which is $30,292 for unit 313 and $27,999 for unit 316, and approve resolution R-1621.
Second.
Any further discussion? Yes, Trustee Youssef?
I'll be brief, but I think it's wonderful that we're transitioning to four-wheel drive vehicles. The times when you need it, you really do need it. We've got a lot of open fields. We've got a lot of forest preserve. We'll back them up. And we have weather conditions. So it's great. Just a little bit of history. When we bought the Escapes, we had $4 a gallon gasoline. And that was part of the driving factor at that time. It turns out that they are not suitable for the demands placed on them in this type of service. So now we're going with a more heavy-duty vehicle, and one that hopefully will provide better service and a better platform for us to keep our residents safe.
Thank you. Thank you for your perspective. Any further discussion? Seeing none, roll call vote, please.
Trustee Barr?
Yes.
Trustee Moy?
Yes.
Trustee Tiesinger?
Yes.
Trustee Youssef?
Yes.
Motion carries.
Are we done?
We're done.
Oh, all right. Updates from the manager, Rick?
I have nothing. Thank you.
Okay. Village clerk, brevity.
April 4th is our next election, and I expect everybody to vote. We no longer can register people here at the village or at the library. So early voting is going to start on Thursday. It's already started. And it will stop Monday, April 3rd. And if you need to register, you can go out to DuPage County Election Commission. And remember, if you go, your children go to the high school of Hinsdale Central, there's a $76 million referendum on that ballot.
Thank you.
If you have any questions, I'll help you. Just call me. Thank you.
Trustee update. Asif, do you want to lead off?
I don't have much to say because normally I get about 2 to 3 hours to think about what I'm going to say at the end.
Okay, all right, okay.
This was a brief meeting. It was a focused meeting. Nothing was sugarcoated. Nothing was glossed over. But we got right to the point and we got done what we needed to do.
It's not that we went extra fast.
This is the way it should be.
That's the way it should be, yes.
Absolutely.
I know, Trustee
and if we
would
all work towards that, that would be a wonderful thing for, not necessarily for our sakes, because we don't mind being here. We got a lot of staff people here. We have people in the audience that are waiting for a particular item, and they shouldn't have to wait an hour and a half or 2 hours just because we're going to have a lot of speech making going on up here. It's unnecessary, and brevity is a wonderful thing. And after saying that, I will say no more.
Appreciate your brevity. Trustee Moy.
Thank you, President Lamalani. I want to thank the board for holding down the fort while I was away last time in Washington, D.C., but spending time with your new grandson is priceless. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Parr, any updates?
No.
Mr. Tiesinger.
Yes, thank you, President Lamalani. It's been several months since we commissioned our Community Enhancement Committee to grapple with the departure of McDonald's, and to that we added the Windsor property. And in recent discussions with some of our residents, including one member of the committee, the suggestion was made to me that I air out the idea of perhaps adding the intersection of 35th Street and Midwest Road to the scope of what that committee is looking at, because that's the area that is going to take the brunt of the traffic from the what Latin students will remember as a natatorium. I was told that Google Maps, when it tells you your suggested driving route, now says, hey, take 35th Street, the traffic is light. And so all the people who live in Saddlebrook are getting a little bit alarmed that they're about ready to be invaded by all this traffic, which the Westmont Village Board somewhat improvidently unanimously approved. There's a lawsuit that's been filed which is trying to reverse that, but who knows what will happen. And so it seemed to me like a very good idea to float that with our board to say, do we want to add that intersection as one of the key areas for our village planner, Housel Levine, to look at? And that reminded me, it's really been some time since we've heard from our Community Enhancement Committee. So I would just, as part of my comments, commend the committee. There are 16 people on it. There's some of the leadership people in our community from business, representing the residents, and chaired by Jeff Kennedy, our former trustee. And so I know they have a six-month limit on their work, and I think with the clock is ticking, and I'd just like to maybe get a status report from them.
As a matter of fact, I've been working on that committee as well, and they'll be meeting hopefully soon because the Commercial Enhancement Committee hasn't met as well for quite a while. So you need to forward your ideas and your recommendation on the 35th issue. It's a valid issue. Unfortunately, our Saddlebrook trustee is not here today, but he could have expanded on that. But the Commercial Enhancement Committee will be meeting as well pretty soon. I'm hoping in the next couple of weeks. I actually talked to Rick yesterday, and I talked to Jeff last week to make sure that they don't forget to meet. It's so important that they need to meet. Did you want to follow up on that?
Yeah, I talked to Chairman Kennedy this afternoon. We connected, Bob and I have sent information along with information from Tracy Mulqueen from the Chamber on our significant stakeholders in the village. And we will be holding a meeting as soon as John Housel can coordinate it with those significant stakeholders as well as that committee to gather input into the update of the plan. So hopefully that's going to be in the next couple of weeks.
Very good. Stuart, do you have any updates?
No, other than on behalf of all of the families of the staff and the families of the board, I'd like to commend the board on the quickness of this meeting.
We're not done yet.
Well, I understand, but you're getting...
Maybe another 2 hours.
Well, it's there is a possibility, but again, an example was the motion that was made to table something, which in fact, rather than debating it, there was a sense it should be changed, and I think that's a good way for the board to think about things in the future.
Thank you. Moving on, let's see. Jim?
At last Tuesday's meeting of the Zoning Board of Appeals, I attended on behalf of the village for the new communication tower that was approved by the Zoning Board of Appeals. So I'll be coming back to the board in a future meeting with a proposal from Verizon, and it's looking likely now that there might also be a T-Mobile proposal attached. So,
Chief, any further updates?
No, nothing at this time. Thank you.
Doug?
After a two-month hiatus, crews were back out taking care of the salt, snow and ice. We didn't forget.
Keep up the good work. Thank you.
Yeah. And we don't like the snow at the golf course, but we had a strong February, but hopefully March will come around.
No golf this week, right?
No, there won't be any golf this weekend, sorry.
Chris?
Just wanted to make note that I think one of the advantages, I guess, and disadvantages of looking super young sometimes is that I've graduated college 11 years ago. I have a lot of experience working in corporate America, Fortune 100 companies, in management, run operations like this. So I do have a lot of experience. I have a lot of ideas as well, and certainly want to keep all of our members happy and informed. But I did just want to point out that I do have a lot of experience. I'm not straight out of school. I have a good idea and a lot of research and input that we've taken very cautiously on how we're going to try to help make some positive improvements. And part of my presentation tonight was to show the direction that we'd like to go in. So I just wanted to point that out.
Your youth is sort of misleading, Chris. Jake, over there? Yeah, we always miss you. No? Okay, thank you. Jason?
The 2016 audit just kicked off yesterday, so that'll be done end of next week, so hopefully next month or two we'll have something to present for 2016.
Any sales tax update?
I think I sent one out last week. So
are we up?
Just on, right?
Just on?
Much, yeah.
Okay. All right. Barry? Bob?
Oh, to me.
Oh, you. We've been waiting for you. We're getting late here.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you, I've been to like 350 of these since I've been here. This might end up being like the fifth shortest. So this is a good way to go for short meetings. Couple things. The Rush project, they're going to have the groundbreaking on April 10th. I think Donna is going to be inviting all the trustees. The Hyatt House, originally they were going to be open in September. It looks like they're going to try to be open in July. So that project's moving quickly. And then the Michael Jordan's restaurant is taking shape quite quickly. They should be open in June. So those are three substantial projects that we have. And then with respect to Trustee Tasinga's comments about 35th Street, I'll bring up the issue with John Housiel. But the caution may be that we have to amend that contract, because if we're going to do the analysis that's going to be required, he's going to have to engage a traffic engineer, and traffic engineers don't work for cheap. So depending on if he's capable of doing it, we'll find out what the cost is. We may have to come back to the board. Okay.
Thank you. May I now have a motion to adjourn the regular meeting of March 14, 2017?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All those in favor say yes?
Yes.
Yes.
Any objections? Okay. Motion carries.
757.